I hope you all are fine and healthy. I welcome you all to RKP online classes. Today in this video we will learn about latitudes and longitude. This is chapter number 2 of your book Latitudes and Longitudes. Students, both latitudes and longitudes are imaginary line. Imaginary here, word imaginary means you are not going to find these lines on earth. They are imaginary. Okay, we have drawn these lines on the globes and maps for our convenience only. So these are imaginary lines that are drawn on the map and globes, and they both latitude lines and longitude lines, these both lines help us in locating the position of any place, in locating the absolute position of any place. So here I am using the word location. I am saying that latitude lines and longitude lines both are imaginary lines which help us to find the absolute location of any place. Here the term location is the position of any place on the earth surface. Location means the position of any place on the earth surface is known as the term location. Hear this thing? And there are two types of location. One is relative location and second is absolute location. Relative location, absolute location. So first we will discuss about relative location. Relative location. Relative location means if we are describing the position of any place in relation to other place. If we are describing the position of any place on the earth in relation to other place, that is known as relative location. We will understand this relative location with the help of example. Suppose my friend wants to come to my home, but I want to tell her my location, the location of my place. If I say that my house is located 2 miles from the school, that means I am telling her the relative location. Okay, I am describing the location of my house in relation to other place, that is the school. So that is the relative location. Sometimes we also use familiar landmarks, means well-known feature of the earth. Like if anyone asks you about your home address, you say that my home is located just to the right of this temple, famous temple, or just to the right of this mall. That means here we are using familiar landmarks. So next is absolute location. Absolute location tells us the exact position where that particular place is located. Like home address. Home address means exact position of our home. So this is absolute location. So we have discussed location, position of a place on the earth surface, and it is further divided into two parts, that is relative location and absolute. Relative location means if we are describing the location in relation to other places. If we are describing the place, the position of any particular place in relation to other place. Okay, but in absolute location, it tells us the exact position where that particular place. Question will arise in your mind that how to locate the place on the earth. As I told you that with the help of latitudes and longitude lines, we can locate the place on the earth. But how we can locate the places on the earth surface? See, the answer to this question is that with the help of these imaginary lines, with the help of latitude lines and longitude lines, these are imaginary lines. With the help of latitude and longitude lines, we can locate the place on the earth. That means we draw the draw the imaginary lines, latitude lines and longitude lines on the maps and the globes in order to find the absolute location. Again, absolute location tells us exact position of that particular place. So with the help of imaginary lines that are drawn on the maps and the globes, we can find the absolute location of any particular place on the earth surface. I am saying that the lines are drawn on maps and globes. But what exactly maps and globes are? See, map is a drawing of the earth surface on a flat paper. It is drawing of the earth surface on a flat paper. As we can't see our earth, okay, we are to go to the space if we want to see our earth planet. Otherwise we can't see, but with the help of map and globes we can see our earth. But what exactly globe then? Globe is a model of the earth. It is a true model of the earth, or you can say it's a replica, similar copy of the earth. Okay. So students, here you can see this is a globe. This is globe, and this globe is a model of the earth. Also, we call it as a replica of the earth or miniature form of the earth, small copy of the earth. So a globe has an axle. It has an axle which help it to spin. As you know, earth rotates on a axle. Earth rotates on its axle. Here the word axle is nothing but the axis. Axle means axis. Axis is any imaginary line that runs from the north pole to the south pole, that connect the north pole to the south pole. Okay, this is imaginary line, or which connect the north pole to the south pole. North pole means the top point on the globe is the north, and this bottom point on the globe is the south pole. Clear? And here you can see one more line is there in the middle of the globe. This line is known as equator, 0 degree equator. This is also latitude line. We will discuss in latitude topic also. So this is equator, any imaginary line that run from east to west direction. Here you can see this is east direction, this is west direction, this is north, this is south. These all are cardinal directions. So any imaginary line that run from east to west, that is equator, and that is dividing the earth into exactly two equal halves. So that is equator, and it is dividing the earth exactly into two equal halves, that is the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. As you know, this is equator, this is the north of the equator, and this is the south of the equator. And this equator imaginary line is dividing the earth into northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. What is northern and southern hemisphere? The part of the earth which is toward the north of equator. Toward the north of equator, this is northern hemisphere. The part of the earth which is to the south of equator is the southern hemisphere. So on map and globe, you are going to find so many lines. Some horizontal lines, some vertical lines. And all these lines are helpful to us in finding the location of any place, absolute location of any place. Now students, we will discuss about latitudes, and then we will discuss about longitudes. So what is latitude? Latitude is any imaginary line that runs from east to west. As you can see, these are latitude lines. The lines, imaginary lines, as I told you that you are not going to find these lines on earth. These lines does not exist on earth. So these are imaginary lines that run from east to west direction. So this is known as latitude line. And here you will see one such latitude line. I have darkened this, that this is another such latitude line, that is equator, 0 degree equator. Equator is any latitude line that divides the earth into two equal halves, that is the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. So part of the earth which is toward the north of equator, which is toward the north of the equator, is known as northern hemisphere. This area is known as northern hemisphere, and the part of the earth which is toward the south of the equator is known as southern hemisphere. So equator is any latitude line that divides earth into exactly two equal halves, northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. And one more important fact about latitude, they are also called as parallel lines. Parallel lines. Why they are called the parallels? Why latitude lines are also known as parallels? Because all the latitude lines are parallel to each other. First we will understand the term parallel. Parallel means if two lines are drawn, and both are moving in same direction, and the distance between them is also same, then those lines are known as parallel. So similarly, we call latitude as a parallel. Why? Because all lines are moving in same direction, and distance between each and every line is also of 1 degree. The distance between each and every line is of 1 degree. That's why they are called as parallel also. Latitude lines are also known as parallel because both moves in same direction from east to west, and the distance between every latitude lines are also 1 degree. So where they are drawn? They are drawn on the globe. Okay, because they help us to locate the places. Now we will read about that equator. Equator is also known as Great Circle. Why it is known as the Great Circle? Because it is the longest latitude line. Here on the globe you can see the longest latitude line is of equator. That's why equator is known as the Great Circle. But if you move from equator to the North Pole, this is North Pole, this is the South Pole. As I told you during the that question in which we have discussed how to find the location of any place, that the top point on the globe is North Pole and the bottom point is the South Pole. So if you move from equator to the North Pole, as you can see, latitude lines, size of latitude lines are goes on decreasing. Now it's small on the North Pole. Similarly, if you move from equator to the South Pole, here you will see the latitude lines, size of latitude lines are goes on decreasing, and it is very minimum at the South Pole. So equator is known as the Great Circle because it is the longest latitude line. Now we will discuss that how many latitude lines are there on the earth. So there are 181 latitude lines. How many? 181. How 181? See, this is 0 degree equator, okay, and this is 90 degree North Pole. So from equator, if we move to the north side toward the North Pole, there are total 90 lines of latitude. One of equator, 90 towards the North Pole. Equator, and see, if we are moving from equator to the North Pole, if we are crossing any every one latitude line, how we will call that latitude line? This is 0 degree equator, this is 1 degree, this is, we are moving toward the north, so we will call it as a 1 degree north, 2 degree north, 3 degree north, 4 degree north, and then we will reach to 50 degree, then 60 degree, 70 degree, and then finally we will reach to the 90 degree L. Okay, in this way we call it. Like if we are moving from equator to the South Pole, 0 degree equator, 1 degree S, 2 degree S, 3 degree S, similarly 80 degree S and 90 degree S. Okay, so how many latitude lines are there? Here you can see equator 1, we will count it as 1 longitude line, and then from equator to North Pole there are 90 latitude lines, from equator 0 degree equator to South Pole there are again 90 latitude lines. So in totality, how many latitude lines are there? Total 181 latitude lines are there, and the gap between each and every line is of 1 degree. That's why we also call as a parallel of latitudes. Next, we will discuss about important latitude lines. So beside equator and North Pole and South Pole, beside 0 degree equator, 90 degree north and 90 degree South Pole, we have four main latitude lines also. So what are those latitude lines? If we move from equator to the north side at 23.5 degree north, we have Tropic of Cancer latitude line. If we move from equator to 66.5 degree north, we have Arctic Circle, which is also another latitude line. And if we move from equator to the end of the North Pole, we have 90 degree north. Similarly, if we move from equator to the south side, at 23.5 degree south, there is a Tropic of Capricorn latitude line. From equator to 66.5 degree south, there is Antarctic Circle, and then we reach to 90 degree south. Clear? So these are four important latitude lines. These latitude lines have a relation with the heat zones. That's why we have marked 23.5 degree as Tropic of Cancer and 23.5 degree in south side Tropic of Capricorn, because they have a relation. These four important latitude lines has a relationship with the heat zones of the earth. So as you know, sun rises in the east, and this area, the area which lies between equator and 23.5 degree north, Tropic of Cancer, and south, that is Tropic of Capricorn. So this area between equator and Tropic of Cancer to the north and equator and Tropic of Capricorn to the south, this area comes under the torrid zone. Torrid zone because this area receives maximum sunlight from equator to 23.5 degree north. That's why we have given the name to this latitude line, Tropic of Cancer, similarly to the south, Tropic of Capricorn. Similarly, from between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle, this line, this area, that they, this area means the places that are situated in this particular area, they will come under temperate zone. Means these zones are neither too cold nor too hot. Okay, because they get the rays of the sunlight, but some amount of sunlight they receive and some they reflect. So this is temperate zone, neither too hot nor too cold. So Tropic of Cancer and between 66.5 degrees Arctic Circle, this is temperate zone. Similarly, if we look from equator to south side, between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle, this is temperate zone. This area comes under the temperate zone. Similarly, North Pole and South Pole, as you know, Earth always revolve around the Sun, okay, and rotate also. So so these two, North Pole and the South Pole, means area between the Arctic Circle and the 90 degree North, Antarctic Circle and 90 degree South, these area come under the category of frigid zone. They come under the category of frigid zone. These are coldest zone of the Earth. That's why these latitude lines are also very important. Why so? Because they has a relation, they all have a relation with the zones of the Earth, heat zones of the Earth. Okay, so this is all about latitude.